a car, a Skoda car, swerved out of control. We've just accessed CCTV footage. Hopefully, we're putting it out for our viewers. Wherein this white color Skoda car, which had four girls, all of them studying in an engineering college, 19, 20 years old, all four of them, it swerved out of control and went and it turned 180 degrees and ran over a man who was sleeping on the pavement, on the footpath. His name has been identified as 30-year-old Ashok. Immediately, he died on the spot. In fact, locals came running and they insisted that the girls were drunk. The police, when they rushed to the spot, the girls were handed over to the police. The locals continued to allege that they were drunk and that is why they lost control. However, interestingly, the police now say that the girls were not drunk. A drunken driving test was carried out in which they had come out negative. Now a case has been registered under negligence leading to death of negligent driving. That is the case that has been registered by the police. Interestingly, one of the four girls is the daughter of a CI from Malakpet. So influential case out here. Hopefully the police is not shielding the accused,
so,
because
yes, that's the
last
the
I spoke
point.
To the
that
police
the
around an hour ago.
Ask. Is there an attempt, Paul, to cover up? Because you're telling us one of the girls is the daughter of a police officer. He's an influential man. And the police is vehemently denying that the girls were under the influence of alcohol. Whereas the eyewitnesses report that this is a clear case of drunken driving. We have two versions here.
Absolutely. In fact, we have a video in which one of the locals who saw the incident happen clearly telling the police who were taking away the girls that the girls are drunk and they should take note of this. The cops are seen on camera saying yes, they will take cognizance of it, and they were seen taking the girls away. However, like I said, a couple of hours I spoke to the police, they happened to tell me they haven't identified the girls yet. They refuse to accept that one of the girls belongs to is the daughter of the CI of Malakpet. So clearly two things here. One, they haven't been booked for drunken driving. If they were, we are waiting for the doctor's version of the story so that we can prove that the girls weren't drunk in this particular case. And the second case, why weren't the girls taken away? Why wasn't a police taken? Why wasn't she taken to the hospital? The second one, several questions being raised by the locals.
Right, and why are their identities being shielded? That's a very serious point, Paul, that you're making, that their identities are not being revealed. That is something we continue to question. Thanks so much for joining us with the latest.